It's no secret that sharing a home with a pet enriches both the human and the animal, and there's nothing like knowing you rescued one that's in need of some special care. Here to tell us about saving the savable is Jeanette Regan from No Kill Pima County and volunteer Justin Pope. Thank you both so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having us.
Nice to see you. And you brought a little friend with you here today, Justin. Who'd you bring?
Yes, I did. This is Revan. He's currently living at the Pima Animal Care Center. Mm-hmm. He's about 8 years old. He came in by a good Samaritan, brought him in middle of December, and
he sees himself. He's get a lot of does. Dogs get active like that.
So one of his he has some medical concerns. We're trying to get diagnostics for, but he also has some issues with other dogs.
Yeah.
So. Finding placement for him is kind of difficult.
Well, and it takes a special home, it takes a special heart, you know, to open your doors to an animal that really, like we were saying, is special care. That's right. Takes special needs. And so is No Kill Pima County a shelter?
No Kill Pima County is not a shelter. Mm-hmm. We have a strong foundation of people instead of bricks and mortar.
Yeah.
And we are a grassroots community that provides services and programs to help save the savable.
Help save the savable. And, you know, going back to giving a dog a special care that it needs, you know, say this one, for example, is not that good with other dogs. And that's one of the programs that you guys have.
That's right. SaveTheSavable.com is a program that helps animals that are a little harder to place. Mm-hmm. That can be seniors, that can be dogs or cats with medical issues. And in this case, sometimes dogs are very people loving, mm-hmm. but they want a family where they're the only dog.
Right.
And so we try to find homes that are appropriate for those animals.
Well, and you know, everybody's different. Just like humans, all dogs are different. They take different combinations of an environment, different types of family situations. And the point is that people can really make a difference for these animals if they foster. They don't even necessarily mm-hmm. have to adopt right away, but how important is fostering for these animals that are in need?
It's vital. The shelter, you know, there's a lot of animals that would do better outside of the shelter, of course. And while they're waiting for their permanent home, a foster home gives them an opportunity to understand the dog's or the cat's temperaments, help them adjust, help them decompress, and just make them more readily adoptable for when that time comes, when they go for adoptions.
Well, and just the stress of being in that shelter, mm-hmm. you know, if they're trying to heal from some sort of sickness, being in that stressful situation will delay them being able to heal. So Justin, what would you encourage people, what would you say to them to encourage them to foster animals or to take care of these little guys?
Fostering is really rewarding. You know, it doesn't take a whole lot of effort, depending on, you know, what you're taking in. Mm-hmm. And there's so many in need that you can match up someone with the right family pretty easily.
Yeah, certainly. And Jeanette, if people want to get involved in other ways, what would you tell them that they can do to best help you?
Well, of course, we definitely need more fosters. We need more people to open up their hearts and their homes. Mm-hmm. Take in a dog or a cat. It's probably the best thing that they can do to help these animals. We also need funds, and we also need volunteers. They can go to SaveTheSavable.com, or they can go to NoKillPimaCounty.org, and there they will find an application to foster. Go to the Pima Animal Care Center and visit all of the animals there and take one home.
Well, there you go. Funds, volunteers, foster homes, all ways that you can help save the savable. So I want to thank you both so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Pleasure
Thanks for
to
having
see
us.
You. Now, to learn more about how you can make a difference and save the most vulnerable pets in our community, call 520-477-7401 or log on to SaveTheSavable.com.